Welcome back. So in the last lecture, we have installed PyCharm editor, and while installing it will ask you if you want to have one icon in your desktop, and then you will see something like this once it's after successfully installed. So double click on that and you will be opened a web page like this. Initially you will not have any projects. I already have projects, so you will be seeing something like this: file, new project. You will be first forcibly asked to create project, then only you will see this backend UI window. Okay, so create project, give any project name. So we wanna give Python testing only. Maybe I will change this so that it stands as unique. Okay, so I will close this existing one, or not required. So give any project name, and then maybe you can project, let's see this later. Click on create, and that will create a new project with the name what you have given here, and it will take some time to set up all virtual environment, and then you will be landed on a page with a dummy project with the name what you have created. It takes around 1 minute time. Perfect. You have seen this is the project, and right now there is nothing inside it, but you have something called VNV. This is more important. I'll tell you how this plays a critical role in this lecture. Okay. Now, so before you write any tests inside it, first of all, you have to set one project interpreter here. Okay, go to add configuration, and then, okay, so I'll create one new Python file. I'll just create one basic file. I would call it as a demo, and then hit an enter. So under the main project, I created a file by right clicking new Python file. I'm not going to write anything now, but once you create that file, come down and you will see here interpreters. Select this and go to interpreter settings. And please watch this carefully. I'm going to tell you one important thing here. By default, when you create project in this PyCharm, this PyCharm also give you one Python environment. Okay, so in this VNV folder, open the scripts. You see that python.exe. We downloaded this earlier separately from our website, right? We said download Python, and we have seen that got downloaded in this local programs Python. Okay, but when you download PyCharm and when you create one project, so this PyCharm guys also on runtime will create one Python environment for you, and they will give it to you. So when you try to run any test in this, this complete project is now dependent upon this Python environment which PyCharm is giving us. Okay, when you select interpreter settings here, you see that it is depending upon this python.exe. This python.exe is coming from your project. As I told, this is created at runtime. That's fine. You might get doubt. Why do I need to bother? It could be my own Python what I downloaded, or what these guys given. At the end, your test should work. That's all your ultimate goal is, right? But that's wrong. I clearly told in the last lecture that this pip install will push all your installed packages into that environment, isn't it? So in the last lecture, we downloaded Selenium from our command prompt, and this Selenium is now pushed to this Python environment. But when you rely on the Python environment which PyCharm is giving for you, in this there is no Selenium package, right? The Selenium package what you downloaded in the last lecture is belonging to that specific Python environment where your local system path. But if you rely on this environment, here there is no Selenium. So your test will start complaining that there is no Selenium package imported. So that's why let's do one thing. We will point our project interpreter. This is where you have to give your python.exe file. Let's point this to our local system path so that we don't have any confusion. Okay, so whenever you create any project, make sure that you remove whatever this PyCharm guys has giving us and use your local project path so that whatever you install tomorrow will be directly updated here as well. You see that? Now in this package, in this environment, what PyCharm has provided, there are two packages, pip setup tools. There is no Selenium. And now go to settings, show all. You see here, this is the one what we need. In your system, it might show or not, I'm not sure. But this is the one we need. Either you can select this directly and click on OK. Or you can actually modify the existing one, what WebCharm have given us. Hit this edit and then give the path of your local python.exe. Okay, so it's in user, owner and app data, right? So remove all this. App data, local, I guess. Okay. Local and programs. Python. In this you have to select python.exe. So select this and hit an OK so that you are changing to your local system one now. Awesome, that's it. So you are done. Good. Click cancel. And now when you open this drop down, you have to... Is it not updated? Oh, because... Yeah. Now when you select this, you will see this option, second one. So select this and hit an OK. When you do that, perfect. You see that when you select your local system path, there are a lot of packages displaying here. But for you, you won't see this all because I already developed framework offline. So you have so many packages. So you concentrate only on Selenium because till this lecture, we just downloaded only one package. Right now, ignore all this. We will slowly get all these packages for our framework development. But you should see this Selenium for sure. So that confirms that you are using right package and right project interpreter. And now apply this and select OK. So that now whatever you write regarding Selenium, it will get identified. So make sure you map this in the beginning before you start lectures. If you don't map it, it's still fine. But when you try to write Selenium, your editor will ask you that please install Selenium and you can automatically do here only. Let me show that as well because people get confused here. Now for example, I'll go back interpreter settings and I would select another one which do not have Selenium. I mean the web's PyCharm one. Okay. Let's say you don't want to map anything and when you start writing, you will write something like this, WebDriver. And then when you move your cursor, automatically this PyCharm intelligently saying you that WebDriver is not present in my environment. Do you want to install and import automatically? So select this. Perfect. Automatically that pip install Selenium, that command PyCharm itself will do and will fix it for you. On fly, at runtime, you can do all these operations. Or if you want to have peace of mind, just make sure you have mapped it correctly with your local system and you need not worry about anything. All right. So that's what about PyCharm basic mapping. And I have also shown how to create new file. So I will pass here regarding Selenium. Because I just shown installation and I don't want to go beyond that before I teach Python basics. So in our next section, let's start about learning about all the Python basics information. I would give you all the information required to develop Python Selenium framework from scratch. So please go through all next lectures in the sequence. Do not skip it if you do not have Python knowledge. Okay. So make sure you follow in sequence, complete all these basics, and then we will jump back to Selenium and start doing automation. All right. So that's all about it. And see you in the next section with some Python knowledge. Thank you.